Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Alicia Williams. I do all things beauty here. So for today's video, I just wanted to do another little get ready with me for makeup. Today I'm going to be using some Jeffree Star. It's the Beauty Killer 2 palette. And I have this highlighter right over here too. So that's what we're going to be getting into. I already have my brows done. Eyelids are primed. So let's just get into the eyes. Okay, so this is how the palette's looking on the inside. I'll put swatches up now. Going into the first shade over here, I want to take Respect and just put it all over the lid since it's supposed to be such a neutral color and it does have a little bit of kickback. I usually blend it all the way up to my brow bone just to give it like a lighter effect because I already know I'm putting color on my lid, so I just wanted to put it up towards the brow bone. Next, I want to play with Blow Up Doll. I want to put her in like the crease and like buff her out. I think we might do a cut crease today, to be honest. So I want to take her, just put her, not too far in, like probably halfway. It is very pigmented. I want to go ahead and take this purple shade right on the end. She's called Death Row, and I want to do the outer corner with her. This shade right here is looking a little patchy. Maybe it's the brush, but if it is, I'll just switch. Let me switch brushes. Because this is looking a little patchy, like right on this area and then up here. So let me get a different brush. Hold on. So this is the brush I'm choosing. It's stained purple. It's a little denser and not as like tip pointy as this one was. So let's just try this one. See if that helps with the shade Death Row. Like the pigment is obviously there. That's looking a lot better. It was the brush. Okay. Okay, so I want to go ahead and cut the crease, but not in the typical way. I want to use this LA Girl Neon Shock Liner. It's in the shade Screaming. So cutting the crease like this. Okay, so bear with me. This is like trust the process right now. This is how it's looking with it cut out with the pencil that I used. Now I want to go ahead and take the fun shade over here called Self-Expression. And I'm going to take this brush over here. I'm just going to pat it on top of the lid and see how it sticks. Hopefully this brings it out more to a yellow than like a green. Okay, so this is how the eyes are looking built up. At first I was worried, but it went on pretty nicely. I know shades like this can tend to get patchy or separate or just not build up properly, but this was not bad. I actually like this a lot. I think especially with like the base we used, that yellow, I think it's just making it pop more so. I really like it. Okay, next shade. So for the next shade, I think I want to use Redemption. I'm like using a lot of mattes, but let's use Redemption and make a wing. Okay guys, so this is how the wings are looking. They look messy, I know. I'm gonna clean it up. So let's start with like complexion so I can do some cleaning before we can do like, you know, any detail work. Okay, so beginning with complexion, I wanna prime my skin. So I'm gonna use my favorite e.l.f. Putty Primer Original and my NYX Plump Me Right Back Serum. Okay, so I wanna clean up the wings. I'm gonna be using my Rare Beauty Concealer in the shade 250W. I just want to clean up the wings, and this is the concealer for the day anyway. I really like to like put a lot down for this concealer. Using a flat end brush, this is the Morphe brush, the M432. I'm cleaning up the wings first. Okay, so now that the wings are cut out, you know, looking all nice and pretty, and I want my concealer to set for a little, I want to use the Rihanna Truffle Matchstick from Fenty Beauty. I like it. I mean, it is more of a dry formula, but I like the color and what it does for me. Now, it's not my favorite out of everything I have, but I don't see any really, no big problems with this. Is that not one of the prettiest shades? I think it's really pretty. I like it. Okay, so now I'm gonna go ahead and blend out my concealer. I'm still using that Soft Real Techniques sponge. Okay, so this is how the concealer is looking blended out. I know it's looking pretty divided, but I want to go ahead and use my Anastasia blush stick. It's in the shade Peach Caramel. It's like a neutral deep shade. I like it. It's pretty. I usually just apply it to the face. I can do it to the brush, but I mean, I don't have any issues with it picking up foundation or anything. Okay, so the blush is looking all nice and seamless. For today's complexion product, I'm only putting it on the bottom part of my face. I don't think I want anything on my forehead today. So it's going to be the Milani 2-in-1 Concealer. It's the perfect concealer. I'm in the shade 08A Warm Sand. And it looks pretty dang good for like my summer tone, I guess, is which I'm in now. I only use about half a pump because it really does have really nice coverage. So I don't need a lot. So maybe about half a pump, like that. And then I'm gonna go ahead and just dot it around. Cause honestly, less is more when it comes to like complexion products for me. I'll look cakey if I use too much. Like, if I use a whole pump, I'm just cakey at that point. It might look great on others, but for me, you can see I'm wearing it. So, I'm just using only a dot. And then you guys can see I put it only down there. I'm gonna blend it up more. So, using the sponge again. So this is how the complexion's looking. I'm telling you, this is like a really good foundation. Conceal and perfect. Like, I would recommend this to a lot of people. Like, even if you want it like full coverage, it's buildable. Like, it's already full coverage just for one pump. If you want to, you can go ahead. But it's like, it was really good coverage. Personally, I only use about half a pump. It's gonna last me forever. I like the way it looks on my skin. It looks like skin, but no blemishes, you know? So I really like this. Definitely 10 out of 10 recommend. Drugstore, probably like $10.99, if not like $11.99. That's a steal. So I'm just gonna go ahead and uncrease my eyes and then set with powder so we can start setting everything else with powder. And as you can see, the Rare Beauty concealer does crease really bad on me. That's just like for a lot of concealers. I have creasy eyelids, I really do. My under eyes just crease, but it wears beautifully itself. I just have to set every concealer. I'm using my Anastasia translucent powder. Just, you know, a little puffer, putting it on the back of the hand. My hand is kind of dirty on the back, so I'll do it on the side. But I'm trying to hurry before I crease again. Just a little bit of powder. I don't need it everywhere. I am a dry skin girl. We're gonna leave this under the eyes, just so we can catch fallout. It's not so much for baking purposes at all. Next, I want to go ahead and set my bronzer, contour, and my blush. So I'm using my Marc Jacobs. This is 250 Tantalize Glow. It's the Omega X3. So I don't know too much about Marc Jacobs besides fragrance, but personally, I got this from TJ Maxx. It was on sale. And I don't remember how much it was on sale for, but look at the shades. Very neutral. We're doing neutral on the face, so it just works out. Taking the bronzer / contour shade, just gonna slab a little. Okay, let's take this blush and run her on the tops of the cheek. Now, the blush is very buildable. It comes off subtle, but I like that. I like to have choices sometimes. Sometimes if I want it loud, you know, I'll do it on purpose. And then I'll conceal it more so to give it more of like a softer look. But this one is more on the subtle side, so I like building it up. Okay, let's go ahead and finish up the eyes. So let's go back with Redemption. We can run her under the eye, but I also want to do like the purple to pink and maybe the neon there. So let's try that. And last but not least, let's take some of this neon shade and try to get her towards the inner corner and whatnot. Okay, so these are how the eyes are looking. I do want to take a sparkle somewhere. How about we'll take Guillotine Dream and put it on the inner corner? I know it's not that bright, but like, I just want to try it. I think the color's pretty. It's definitely on like the silvery side, but it's like a subtle silver. It's pretty. Not mad at it. And then just to play with one more color just for fun, it's not gonna make much of a difference at all. I want to take Soul Sucker, since it's like a little shiny iridescent kind of black, if you will. I don't think it's gonna show up though, because I know how shades like these do. Just putting it a little on the outer corner, just a dot. Now getting into Miss Ice Crusher. This is the Jeffree Star highlight palette. They actually were on sale together. My sister, she got them for me as like a deal of getting them together. I think it was like $50 together. So she saw the deal and she was like, oh, this is perfect for me, I guess. And I mean, I'm excited. It's a Skin Frost Pro palette, and look at the packaging. Pretty. These are the shades. I'm gonna put swatches up now. So looking at the shades and then looking at my makeup, okay, let's do Avalanche on the inner corner and brow bone. Blinding. She just made that gunmetal shade blinding. Is it called Guillotine? Just became blinding. That was a perfect pop. And then brow bone. Let's do Snow Job. Put it on the tops of the cheek. Ooh, it looks kind of green. It looks very much green. It's giving me fairy vibes. Pretty. Very much like fairy vibes for a highlighter. I think I want to take Pillow Me and just put it more on the back of my face so that we're not like screaming green. You know, just a little. Hopefully it's not running too dark on my face. Oh, there we go. It toned it down a little. Just a little. Okay, I think I'm gonna take Ice Pick Headache, this like pinkish looking shade, and just put it on the top of my nose, and then Cupid's Bow. Gorgeous. This is so pretty. It's blinding. Now there is some fallout with the highlight. Oh my gosh, look at that. There is some fallout with the highlight, so you just gotta like be aware of that and probably dust off your face. It's not the craziest thing I've had for fallout, but you know, if I put it down in a certain spot, that's where I want it. I don't want it everywhere. Since I finished my liner, I wanted to add Fula from Juvia's Place, the duochrome, just as a little detail. I'm gonna go ahead and set my makeup using the ColourPop Pretty Fresh Hyaluronic setting spray, just to give me a little glow, and then I'm gonna go ahead and do lashes, lips, and that's the end of the video. So I'll come back with lashes and lips on to wrap up the video. So hi guys, thank you so much for making it to the end of this video. Sorry about my hand, it's completely dirty from making all of this. So for lips, I did finish off with my Fenty Beauty gloss. She is in the shade Ruby Milk. Gorgeous. I thought, you know, the subtle flush of pink would be nice for the eyes to give it some more pink. You guys can't see my outfit too much, but it's more of a romper. Very cute. I thought the colors went nicely enough, so that's why I picked it. Lashes, I'm wearing Kala Kimmy Fox Make Weightless Volume Curl. It's in the style Kimmy. So these are the lashes. I don't know if you guys can see it that well, but that's how they're looking. I really enjoyed playing with everything today. I feel like it's all a vibe. Okay, so I really enjoyed playing with everything. This palette really gave me such party girl vibes. Like, I don't think I would take it unless I was going to a party. Like, this would be like a party palette. As I assumed, the neonness, it died down. It's more muted. It's like a chartreusey kind of green. Using the yellow, I feel like it made it pop at the moment, but after setting my face, I feel like it faded. So this is as good as it's gonna get. I like how everything came out. Highlighter, I'm gonna keep playing with her. I think it's pretty. Now, not everyone's into highlight like they used to be. Highlight used to be everything, but I think it's very much pretty. It's just fun. I like it. So if you enjoyed today's video, thank you so much. You can give me a like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.